Hello everyone, this is Direwolf20, and welcome to episode 15 of Direwolf20's Let's Play series. My farm is working out pretty well. You can see I'm still working on getting more and more carrots. There we go, I actually must have just gotten enough, because a few more got planted. Sweet. So we're going to keep as many carrots in here as possible, try and get us some seeds as well. I wouldn't mind terribly speeding up the growth rate of some of these plants, but we'll get into that a little bit in the nearby future. For now, what I'd like to work on is maybe switching gears a little bit from growing plants to some kind of animal farm. I think the main thing I would like to have here is a farm that's responsible for taking care of getting me a lot of cows. So I want to stick with the MFR work that I've been doing the last episode or two. So we're going to use Mine Factory Reloaded once again, and we're going to use a couple different blocks this time to set up what I hope will be a super efficient and super accurate and working properly cow farm that I can use for, you know, all kinds of good purposes. Now, as you may recall, last season I tried to set up a cow farm, and no matter how many times I did it, something just kept happening to my cows. So hopefully this time around we'll have some better luck and I'll manage to keep a stable cow farm going so that I can go ahead and make myself a whole bunch of steak. Sounds good. Then I just need some potatoes and I'll have a lovely meal. Anyway, let's get started. So I've already got the things I need to get my cows breeding, which is the wheat. So we're going to want to, you know, maintain that wheat. And there's a couple things we're going to want to set up here. We're going to want a breeder. This is going to be responsible for Mine Factory Loaded for breeding our animals. We're going to give it wheat and it's going to encourage the animals to breed by using the wheat. Same way a player would, but it's going to be automated. And then the other thing, well, there's a couple other blocks that we're probably going to want to play with and work with in order to get this thing working. So why don't I start getting some of the crafting materials I need properly ready, and then we will be right back. All right, guys, we're back, and I want to start working on something that should help me out. It's an item from forestry. All I'm going to need is a book, a chest, and a crafting table. And I believe this will get me the work table from forestry. Sweet. This thing's kind of cool. It should make it a little bit easier for me to craft the kind of things that I craft commonly. The reason for that is because of the following. So first off, let's take a look at something that I'm making all the time, at least right now. And that would be the machine block from Thermal Expansion. So if we take a look, there's lots of things that are called machine blocks. All right, basic machine block. Okay, basic, you get the gist, machine frame. All right, so in order to make a machine frame, we need glass, iron, and a tin gear, and the tin gear is made with copper and tin. Okie dokie. So let's go ahead and demonstrate how the work table can work to our advantage. All you have to do is place a recipe on the left side here. So in this case, I want to use tin, not iron, and you'll notice that it makes a tin gear. I can now pull the tin gear out of here. Cool. You'll notice it also placed a tin gear on the right-hand side of the work table. This is what's cool about this machine. Check this out. Now, if I take this tin gear and I teach the machine how to make, for example, the basic machine frame, there we go, and pull that out, it'll record that. Now, if I want to make another tin gear, I just click on the tin gear and it brings up the recipe again. And if I want to make another machine frame, it'll bring up the machine frame again. And it'll pull those items from the inventory on the bottom here. So you'll notice every time I make a tin gear, I'm losing 4 tin and 1 copper. And anytime I make the machine frame, I'll lose one of my gears. Cool, right? Now, if you want, you can also right click on these guys. What it'll do is it'll record the last 9 recipes that you made. So, you know, after we make a few more recipes in here, it might start running out of space and it'll start overwriting recipes when you use new ones. If you want to make sure it doesn't overwrite a recipe so that it sticks around at all times, go ahead and right click it like so. And you can click the little X here to clear out the pattern. So if I go ahead and do this and pull out some redstone, boom, I've got a redstone reception coil. Nice. That's what's up. So one thing I want to make right now, there's actually a handful of things. I decided there's been a couple different ways that I've used Mine Factory Reloaded to make animal farms in the past. And I want to go with something a little bit new, a little bit unique. So I'm going to combine a few different mods to make what I suspect will be a super simple and efficient way of doing the animal farm. In the past, you've seen me have multiple pens, right, with Mine Factory Reloaded, and you've seen me, you know, pull out babies when they're young, stick them into a separate pen, and then when they grow up, the grinder takes care of them. That just seems like a lot of extra effort and work. What I'm going to do is going to be not super easy, but it's also going to be pretty straightforward and hopefully not too shabby. So I'm going to go ahead and make a bucket here, and you know what else I'm going to want is some copper gears. I definitely want this thing to know how to make copper gears. And I think thermal foundation, yeah. We want a couple of these, and I'm going to lock that recipe in too, because copper gears we're making left and right as well. What I want to make is the induction smelter. I don't think I have one of these yet, right? So the induction smelter is going to be useful. I need copper gears, I need Invar, and I need a bucket. I think the only thing left to get here is Invar. This is typically the way... Do I have any Invar? I've got one. So let's get some ferrous and a couple iron. I'm pretty sure I don't have an induction smelter, right? Magma, fluids... sawmill, so yeah, we're definitely going to want to get this. Luckily, Ender.io can also make these for us. Typically, if we wanted to make Invar, we would have had to have used an induction smelter, or we would have had to have some dusts or something. We'd have to grind down and combine the dusts manually. You can either do this, like I said, in the induction smelter, or you can make the dust by hand, which is made with some pulverized iron and ferrous and a crafting table. Either way, but for now, we're going to go ahead and make the induction smelter. I don't know if I can shift-click this in here. We're going to find out, though. Oh, wow, look at that. I can. Sweet. So do I have everything I need? As long as I place the Invar in here, I do. Nice. Now, I'm not going to be making induction smelters all the time, so I'm going to hold off on... you know what's actually cool about this? Is it used the hardened machine frame? It figured out that I wanted it to actually use a basic. That's kind of cool. I don't think there's a way to actually clear this. But it'll clear next time you craft something after we craft a few more things. So I've got my induction smelter. The reason I wanted to get this is because there's a way I want to handle the feeding of my animals. There is a feeding... Yes, station. A feed station. This is from Railcraft. It's a very nice way to handle feeding animals because A, it only has one inventory slot, and B... Even better, it doesn't require power. So it's going to be a very nice, low-cost way of keeping these animals fed. So we're going to get the feeding station here. However, it requires steel. Now, there's a couple different ways to make steel. Typically, steel is made through Railcraft with a complicated machine. However, steel happens to be ore dictionaried with industrial craft refined iron, which typically you would need a complex blast furnace from industrial craft. However, it looks to me like there's an induction smelter recipe to get refined iron, and that is 1 iron and 4 charcoal, or 1 iron and 2 coal powder. So I'm going to go ahead and grab some charcoal here. So in order to get that, it looks like I'm going to want to smelt up some wood. So I'm probably going to want to smelt more than this. Go ahead and just cook that up. That'll get me a little bit of charcoal. I could have sworn I had more wood than that, but that's why I have a farm outside to handle this stuff. Dun dun dun. Also, a neat trick too while I'm working on this. There we go. Gotta love chopping down trees all in one go. A lot of people have asked me, like, why don't I include some mods that, like, make it so that you automatically, every time you chop down a tree, regardless of what you use, it cuts down the whole thing. I kind of like, you know, starting out with low-level stuff, like, you know, having to chop them down manually, and then eventually getting to the point where I have better tools that can chop it down automatically for you. So, by the way, all Tinker's Construct tools, when you right-click them, will place the block on your hotbar to the right. So, for example, when I right-click this axe, it should place down oak saplings for me. Sweet. Gotta love that. Nice. All right, one more. Come on, oak sapling. There you are. And that applies to the torch as well, right? So if I right-click my pickaxe, it places the torch because the torch is to the right of the pickaxe on my hotbar. Okay. So now I can cook up just a little bit more charcoal and combine that with iron. So I'm going to need 4 pieces of steel here. And I'm also going to need a rolling station. So let's go ahead and get one of those set up. Rolling station, I believe, is 4 pistons, iron, and crafting table. So that won't be too shabby. We'll get that, and we'll get the rolling station with 4 pistons. I probably need more redstone than I have. 4 pistons. Beautiful. And I'm going to need a total of 8 more iron, right? 1 for the rolling station. There we go. And this is from Railcraft, and we're going to be doing some stuff with Railcraft this season, so you'll be seeing more of the rolling station. Both of these require power, by the way. So one, two, and I'll throw down the induction smelter here because that's going to be on the same line set as all my thermal expansion machines. And for now, I'll throw the rolling machine here. We might wind up moving it down the line. So let's combine iron plus charcoal to get, ideally, refined iron. And then we'll be able to get steel. In the meantime, let's go get some carrots. I shouldn't have any problem getting carrots. There's probably none in my barrel just yet, because remember, we're waiting for this thing to fill up a full stack of carrots. But for now, I can get the four that I need. Heading back inside. And just a few gold nuggets, or, you know, probably a few more than that. How's this thing done? Yet, almost, possibly. One more operation to go. Take out that charcoal so we don't leave any in there. And then what we need to do is combine the four refined iron in the rolling machine. And you'll notice that that gets four steel plates. Now, if you put more than one set of four in here, it would operate until it got down to the last set. And it would leave that pattern in there so you can automate this machine and pipe more in. But if you want to manually force it to craft that last set, you have to click on it. And you'll notice that the crafting process begins. It does use quite a bit of power. Wow. But that's okay. We have our steel plates, and I should now be able to make my feed station. So let's go back to the feed station. Okay. What's nice about this feed station, by the way, is it's a pretty intelligent machine, meaning it won't overpopulate the earth with animals. It's going to detect how many animals are nearby and stop feeding if there's too many. So let's go ahead and place this thing right in the center of this area. I did make this a 9x9, right? Out of my way, stinky cows. There you are. So you can see that looks like nice and spot on in the middle. If I drop some wheat in here, it may start feeding them. Okay, yeah, it did. Nice. It's not terribly fast, but it'll definitely get the job done. And you'll see it'll kind of start to feed and encourage animals nearby to breed. Nice. It actually might have started detecting right away that there's too many cows nearby, so maybe that's why. There we go. No. Two of them. There we go. Baby cow. Nice. So the feed station does a nice job of, you know, feeding animals. So that's step one. We have an automated way to breed our cows. It, like I said, won't overpopulate. So eventually it'll see that there's so many cows nearby, it'll stop feeding them. Next up, let's find a way to get rid of the cows and get ourselves some steak. For that, we're going to want the grinder. The grinder is a very cool device from Mine Factory Reloaded. What we're going to use this thing for is to kill our cows and get some steak from them. That's going to require books and an Invar sword and a machine frame and some tin gears. I can handle half of that right now. I'm going to need an extra 3 tin gears. We're going to need one. Well, we've already got the machine frame. We're definitely going to need another redstone reception coil. We're going to need books, plastic sheets, and an Invar sword. Do I have any more Invar? I think I must have used up. Well, I can demonstrate making Invar. I'm going to make a handful of the stuff because it's always good to have. 8 and 4. We'll drop this into our induction smelter, which is pretty much made for making Invar. And then what we'll do is, I guess I'll put this I'll call my railcraft chest. So real quick, you can see I added another filter here. Mine Factory Reloaded and Railcraft can both live in this chest. Sound like a plan? Cool. So if I get myself an Invar sword and couple pieces of leather. It's my last two leather, but believe me, guys, leather's not going to be hard to come by in just a few minutes. So get myself two books, Invar sword, and then, of course, some more plastic. Plastic sheets. And we should be good to make the grinder. Maybe not. You know what? Invar sword doesn't stack, so actually I can do it here because it doesn't matter if Invar stacks or not. It puts in the recipe whether it's down here or not. Do I have everything in there? No, I need my books and my plastic sheets. Nice. Oh, I'm liking the work table. I'm liking it a lot compared to the crafting station. Crafting station's great, don't get me wrong, but that work table is very, very handy. Especially when, like I said, you want to craft more tin gears, copper gears. You don't have to remember anything. Just boom, you're good to go. So make sure to lock down the recipes that you want locked, and we don't care about the other ones being here because they're not commonly crafted. So I've got the energy conduits that I'm going to want. Let's go ahead and grab a chest for the time being, and eventually we'll upgrade this thing. So there's a, ooh, nighttime. Let's sleep through the night. And there's one more thing I want to get before I head over to this area, and that's a lever. So let's just make that real quick here. And I'll tell you why in a minute. So long story short, and I'm gonna actually place this thing right out here, I think. I should be able to place it out here, and it should work. There we go. That looks good, right? And I'll put the chest behind it, and I'm gonna put a lever on the side. What the lever does is when a redstone signal is applied, it prevents the machine from working. So, as a quick demonstration here, if I placed, you'll notice that this machine's currently running, right? If I place a lever on the side with a redstone signal, no more running. So redstone signal applied, darn it, equals, you know, that. That thing broke really fast, by the way. I'm guessing there might be something a little bit wrong. There we go. And you're back in there. Nice. So, this thing's good. These guys are breeding. You can see we're getting cows. Now, there's one problem that I've got if I want to place the grinder here. Typically, how'd you get outside? Typically, what you would see happening is if the grinder is out here, it's just going to kill everything inside. It won't kill babies, but what would probably happen if I just left this thing running all the time is it would, as soon as the babies grew up to adults, it would immediately kill them, and then we'd have a serious problem because we'd run out of cows pretty quickly. So what I want is a way to only kill the animals when there's enough of them there to rebreed after, you know, the killing takes place. And for that, there's a couple different mods I can use, but there's one in particular that I've already started using, and that's Batania. It adds a block that can do something really cool. Let's take a look. If I grab my Lexica Batania, which I believe is actually in the chest inside my house. I've got so many tools anymore that I decided to forget the tool racks. I had to go with a whole chest up here because I just wasn't able to handle it. So if we jump through to natural apparatus, Eye of the Ancients. Basically, what this does is you hook up a comparator and it will emit a redstone signal equal to how many animals are nearby, starting with two. So if it detects two animals, it'll strength one. If it detects three animals, of strength two, etc., etc. So what I'm going to do is create a similar but not identical system to what I made before. I'm going to need four mana steel and some living rock and an Eye of Ender. Now, hopefully, yes, cool. You and I did kill some Endermen earlier, so I have one more Ender Pearl. That's good. I can get my Eye of Ender, and we'll put this in here and exchange it for four iron. And I should have, if I run back over here, some living rock. Good. Drop this in here. And I should be able to craft my Eye of the Ancients. Nice. So because we've got a ton of animals over there, we should have a strong output signal. What I'm going to do is craft a couple gates and come back here in a minute. I'm going to want some red alloy wire. I'm going to want all my gate components. And I'm going to want some redstone, which I've got. And I'm going to want probably some netherrack or some nether quartz. I know I'm going to need that. Let me craft the comparator. I'm going to need a not gate and a couple other things, and then we'll be back. It's time to shrink down to Ender Mini size. Dun dun dun. Ender Mini. What I wouldn't mind having would be just a regular old shovel. Do I not have a regular old shovel? I could grab my Dire Vader, but I want to have just a normal shovel, so why don't I make sure I make one of those? I don't care if it's a slow one, it'll be fine. It's just for temporary uses for the most part. But I want to clear out underneath my animal farm is where I'm going to build this little bit of logic circuitry so that we can detect when there's a lot of animals near here. So this is the center block. So I want to make sure not to dig, you know, too deep. I don't want to have a lot of cows falling on my head, but if I dig through across, Oh, that was close. That was supposed to be dirt, by the way. There we go. Cool. So let's make sure we have a little bit of area to work with. So if I were to, for example, hit this guy like so, I can probably shift out of Enderman form, because this might be a little bit hard for you guys to see on YouTube. I can see it pretty well, but there we go. Cool. Alright, let me clear out some space, and I'll come back when I've got just enough open area to work in. Alright, so let's give this eye a try. I believe the radius it said was 6 blocks in all directions, so just kind of sticking him roughly in the middle of this area should suffice. It might not be a bad idea, just to make it easy for me to see where the exact middle is I'm going to set up a waypoint real quick. New, we'll just call it whatever, it doesn't matter what we name it. And then when we go back down, we should be able to see. There we go. Alright, so I'm 1 block off from the middle. That's fine. So, there we go. Now, if we check our redstone comparator strength, so that's the knot gate, this is the comparator, what we should be able to detect is how many animals there are nearby based on the redstone signal strength. And somehow, I don't have my redstone on me anymore. I swear I had it like a second ago. Where'd I put it? I must have sorted it. Speaking of, I need to go mining. I don't know if I did that between last episode and this one like I said I would. I might have. I kind of forget. Alright, so the redstone signal strength should be high right now. Power level 15. That's exactly what I would have expected. Now my machine is right here, so that's where I want to get my redstone signal to. So in order for this to work, we basically want to loop our redstone signal around enough that we weaken the signal strength. So let's do this, right? That should be sufficient. Now if I throw red alloy wire down, is that going to work? Alright, and then what I want to do is hit up a knot gate from here on, right? So we'll have a knot gate, and so he's outputting a redstone signal because he's receiving one on this end. If he's, well, no. He should be, but he's not. Interesting. This one should be strong enough to toggle this off. Alright, one sec, I'll be right back. I want to figure out how I can do this. Oh wait, positive and negative, huh? Ooh, I have an idea. If I had a lever... See, I'm no good with vanilla comparators, but if it's got this nifty little tooltip on the side, that might help. Lever. So I thought that would decrease it. The output strength. Alright, I'll come back in a minute. Alright, so two things, guys. Number one, those cows are loud. Let's handle that. What I'm going to need to make is U plus U equals note block. And a note block surrounded by wool, hopefully of different colors, is okay. Gets me a sound muffler. Nice. You can go somewhere. As can you, you, and you. The sound muffler should help out with the loudness of the cows. Ah. Silence is golden. It'll also get rid of the sound of you breaking blocks, and that usually annoys me a little bit because I'm like, why am I not hearing myself breaking blocks? But okay. Anyway, I got the subtract feature to work on this thing. I had to shift right click it with a screwdriver. I don't know why exactly that's showing as, okay, negative, positive. But one way or another, when I flip this lever, when 14 goes in, 1 comes out. So it subtracts the redstone signal strength. So now I should be able to do something like this. And will the knot gate work for me? Nice. That's what I wanted to see. All right, so then we can run this up to here. And you'll notice that all of a sudden it went off. What's up with that? So signal strength of 1, not strong enough to keep the knot gate on? I don't know. I'll have to play with it a little bit. So I'll come back in a minute here and figure out what I need to do. So the lever here is activating the redstone signal. Derp. So there's your first dire derp of the season. Well, that's probably not. I've probably dire derped quite a bit by now, haven't I? Anyway, now that we're going to get this thing behaving properly, what we should be able to have here is... Okay, so if redstone signal strength is 15... Okay, cool. That should work. Let's just try this real quick. Yeah, that's fine. I don't need that. I was going to have a repeater in there, but it's not necessary. So as long as we're, you know, detecting animals nearby, it will go ahead and keep this wire on. It doesn't look like it's on, but it is because it's such a weak signal. It's signal 1 of 15. And then this will keep this off. But once this is no longer detected, it'll apply a redstone signal up here, keeping this thing from running. Cool. So let's go ahead and place our eye back down. I can get rid of my waypoint, remove. And we should be ready to test this. The one other thing we're going to need here, though, is power. So let me real quick run a power line across. I'm going to dig under here a little bit and just run this straight across as an Endermini, because those are the correct way to do this. It's really nice being able to just do this. And if I remember correctly, Enderminis can run pretty well. So I am going to need to I might have to do something cool here. That would be fun. Let's see if we can do something cool. So I'm going to need more power conduits, maybe? Or do I have enough? Let's see. Now, I don't want this killing all my animals, so let's put that redstone lever back on there just to make sure, because right now it'll probably be running. I want to keep it off, because I don't want it killing all my animals while I'm still configuring this. That would be unfortunate. Took me a while to get those cows. There we go. So now we should have power. I swear, it sounds like my whole game is muted because I've got that muffler there. All right, let's make something cool. All right, so silicon plus redstone should come together to make this stuff, which is redstone alloy. And I can get redstone conduits from Ender.io, which are pretty similar to red alloy wire, except like most Ender.io blocks, they can exist in the same block space as other conduits. So what I should be able to do here, once I have a few redstone alloy, just waiting for the last one to cook up. Man, I should really upgrade that capacitor again to an even faster one. But there we go, bring it over to our crafting table. Get ourselves redstone alloy wire. What I need to test, and this is really crucial right now, is whether or not this stuff will hook up to red alloy wire. So that's the real catch, right? Will it or will it not? So for now, let's break this. We're gonna keep this on. Can this connect? It looks like to me it is, right? Maybe not. Let's see if I can use the Yetta wrench here. There's a little trick I can try. If I right-click on the bottom of this thing, maybe not. All right, something else I'm going to try real quick. So this stuff, pretty similar, redstone alloy stuff, but put conduit binders around it, and you get yourself insulated redstone conduit, which is slightly different and has 16 channels of redstone signal strength on it. So I'm wondering if I can get this guy to connect. If I right click the bottom of this, it should force him to connect. That's what I wanted to be able to do. I guess we're just gonna have to test it and see, because it's not giving me any visual representation as to whether it's working or not, but let's hook it up. So if I, nope, not you. You, 1, 2, cool. Nice, look at that. Now, are you keeping this thing powered? We're going to have to test by removing the lever on the side. So, you are. Beautiful. Darn it. These things shouldn't have that easy of a time to break. Okay, so you'll notice idle, because it's receiving a redstone signal from here. Now, as soon as I hook this up, boom, it should stop the thing from being idle. Okay, it'll start going down from idle, and it'll start operating. Now watch this. We're taking care of the cows. Nice. And we should be getting beef and leather. And another side effect that we're going to get is mob essence. This is cool stuff. We're going to use this later on down the line. Boy, I'm really glad I set up that sound muffler, right? Now, once we get to a point, it should stop killing and it should immediately switch to idle. And I'm going to put the lever back on there just in case something's wrong with my design and it doesn't work, because I don't want all my cows to die. But we should eventually... Oh, by the way, it only has a certain... The grinder really only has a 5x5 radius, so I should probably shrink this down. Let's go ahead and push these guys over here. I'm going to turn this off for a minute, and I'm going to tighten up the pen, I think, because it's a little bit tight. Yeah, let me turn this off, and I'll come right back. All right, guys, I forgot that this thing has such a short range and I couldn't upgrade it. So right now, everything should be pretty tight. Actually, I should probably tighten this up a little bit more, like here. Come on, cow, out of the way. And yeah, I also brought this inside one more block closer so I could have a little bit more room inside the pen. Yeah, I forgot. That's one of the few blocks you can't upgrade the range on, unfortunately. So you get out of the way and you get out of the way. By the way, you can't have multiple animals in this pen, so the pig is going to have to be in a separate farm if I want to farm pork. But this should work now. So if I flip the lever off, you can see it's idle. Nice. The reason being is that there's not enough animals nearby. So the signal strength of the output here is probably too weak. So if we wanted to encourage this thing to run, all I need is a bit of wheat. Sweet. See what I mean about how it's a little disconcerting having no sound at all because, you know, the muffler's there? It has a pretty short range, but let's feed these guys, okay? So once they start breeding, okay, we should wind up with enough babies to raise the count. And we might have enough idle here. Let's see. Not yet. It's still supplying the signal, so not quite enough. Did I feed as many as I could? Alright, so still not quite enough. That's okay. I'll come back in just a second. Let's see. Yep, not yet. Alright guys, I'm feeding a bunch of animals again. This should cause some more babies to spawn, and what we should hopefully see is once that happens, there we go, the idle timeout is running. So once this is running, it means it's going to start killing animals. And once a couple of them die, it should lock up again and prevent any more from dying. Nice! That is working perfectly. So you can see I cleared out some of the terrain, or some of the fences here. This thing should be pretty functional at this point. I'm going to go ahead and throw my wheat into the feed station. That'll encourage breeding. All I really need to do at this point is set up a way to pipe some wheat directly over to the feed station, and I can easily do that with the input-output setting of the Better Barrel. I'll just hook up the ender conduit that's already down there to be input/output. Then any wheat that lands or gets pulled out of the farm here will go ahead and pump directly into there. Speaking of, this farm's a little slow, so maybe next episode I'll work on speeding it up a little bit. That should be a good and fun project. For now, DireWolf20 signing off. Hope you guys enjoyed the episode. We will come back next time. I want to speed up this farm a little bit, and there's probably a few other things I'd like to work on. Probably get onto some armor and a few other things. For now, the sound muffler is doing its job. I might move it. It's, like I said, a little disconcerting having, like, no sound. So, we'll see. If I'm spending any significant time near the cows, I'll probably put it back. But I think for now, it just creeps me out having, like, no game sounds at all when you're near that sound muffler. There's also a rain muffler, by the way. So if you hate the sound of rain, you can, you know, get rid of that. I'll throw this in here. Alright guys, DireWolf20 signing off. Hope you enjoyed the episode. Different take on an animal farm, I know, but I think it was pretty cool, and I think it really worked out well. Alright everybody, take it easy.